Fetish guy. And yes, people, I asked the director if I could use him as an example. Thank you, director. I appreciate it.
No problem.
I can bet. Do you guys know what fetish is? Fetish is the idea of being fit, but also love eating at the same time. I can bet $100. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I said $100 that most of you in this room can relate to this as well. Before I start my talk, underneath your chair, you will have a pencil and a paper. Please, I will give you a few moments to grab those items.
Music.
Now, I want you to write down the first word that comes into your mind after I ask the following question. How do you feel today? Don't think about it, just write it down. Sad, happy, stressed, sleepy, angry. Who knows? Secondly, I want everybody to stand up. Stand up, stand up. We're gonna do that fitness thing, you know?
Dim light.
Don't forget to turn on your lifesavers. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna split the room in half right down the middle. This side will scream live. That side will scream live. When I point to your side, I want you to call your word nice and loud. Ready? I said, are you ready? Yeah, that's right. I want to see that enthusiasm. Ready? And write down, how do you feel now? You thought I was gonna come in here and do some weird, difficult exercise. But you thought wrong. I changed your attitude with some physical activity. Would you believe me if I told you I haven't been into fitness all the time? But the Oscar you see now on this stage made a change. You see, it wasn't to grow muscle. Okay, maybe just a little. Or the physique I wanted, meaning the physical appearance. But what kind of issues is society dealing with when it comes to self-image? Insecurities. Insecurity. The first thing insecurity tells you what success should look like. But you come to realize that you cannot be that. So you start to become insecure. I remember dealing with some self-confident issues. This dates back when I was in middle school and at the beginning of high school. I remember dealing with some self-confident issues. Just like I was dealing with insecurity problems, most of you are dealing with the same problem right now. But ever since I changed my mindset, the mindset of a winner, I feel better about myself. As an example of how I overcame my insecurity, I had to change my ways. I had to change the way of how I love, how I looked at myself. I was reflecting on what makes me happy. I noticed that on the days I didn't work out, I felt unhappy. But in the days I did work out, I was more motivated, more joyful, and much happier. I knew this couldn't be a coincidence. I traded my insecurity for self-confidence. And when you do that, ladies and gentlemen, you are able to break through obstacles easier. Now, you literally ripped insecurity apart. Now, life hits you with fear. You see, life is about living. And fear is what's holding you back from your fullest potential. Fear will come to you in many ways. Fear of self-doubt. Fear of self-love. Fear that you're not able to lose a couple pounds. Fear that you can't do it. Fear of what people might think of you. Fear of life, period. If you want to exercise, you have to set measurable goals. You cannot expect to do 100 push-ups in one day, when in reality, you struggle to do 5. You have to set a goal of 25, and then do an increasing of 5 to 10 push-ups every other week. You have to look fear right in the eyes and tell it, "I ain't scared of you, fear. I will eat you up, girl!" How to tackle fear. Number one, take action. Stop sitting around and wait for others to do it for you. Number two, be persistent. Number three, don't take failure personally. There will be times you fall, but you have to get back up and continue the fight. Number four, do things differently. Stop doing what other people do. You have to create your own path. You have to build your own path. You are your own path. Five, don't be so hard on yourself. There will be times you get stressed and things you get depressed over. But just remember, there's no such thing as smooth mountains. If you want to make it to the top, then there's sharp bridges that must be stepped over. Number six, treat the experience as something you can learn. In other words, everyone learns from their mistakes. You see, most people are afraid of the thieves that come into the night to steal all of your things. But there is a greater thief in your mind who is after your dreams. His name is doubt. If you see him, call the cops, because he's wanted for murder, for he has killed more dreams than failure ever did. He will leave you blinded, divided, and turn you to a kinda. You see, kinda is lethal. You know what kinda is. You kinda want a career change. You kinda want to get straight A's. You kinda want to make it to honor roll. You kinda want to be fit. You kind of want to be healthier? Simple math, no numbers to crunch. If you kind of want something, then you kind of get the results you want. That's right. See, what is your dream? What ignites that spark? Let me tell you something. The television execs fired Oprah. They said she wasn't fit for TV. But guess what? Guess what? She kept going. Critics told Beyoncé she couldn't sing. She went to depression, but guess what? She kept going. Director Vibra was told by the district he couldn't open a charter school. A charter school that would allow students to attend a four-year university. A charter school that has changed the life of many others, including mine. Do you think director said, oh, well, I'm just gonna give up? No, director kept on going. Over the 25 past weeks of my servant learning project, I was so busy changing mindsets of individuals. Please take a look at this video of how I help my students through fitness.
There is nothing as powerful as a changed mind.
If you want something out of life, if you want to change yourself, if you want to acquire something, if there's some goal that you want to reach, changing your behaviors, overcoming negative habits, it's challenging. It's hard.
The only thing that's gonna make you happy, my friend, in this year or any other, is to step up. It's to raise the standard, it's to discover what you're capable of and feel that incredible power of pushing through whatever's holding you back and get to the other side of more of your true self. That's what this game's all about.
Let's go.
One more.
This program has helped me lose my confidence. Not only that, but also inspire you to eat healthier and lose weight.
Change my possibilities of my mindset by changing myself into a more self-disciplined person and creating peace in myself. I no longer are in the streets or no longer doing negative things.
Become a leader, not just here at GPA, but also around my community.
This program made me feel like I couldn't do it, but then I just started working harder, and with the motivation of, you know, Oscar and everyone that was here, it helped me a lot. And I really appreciate it.
If you want something, you have got to be relentless.
This program was to help people in need of a lifestyle change. My students had issues. They had their mind just... But I knew I had to change a lot of things about them. I had to change their eating habits. I had to change the way they looked at life. I've had to change the way they look. I had to make them believe that they could do it, that anything was possible. These individuals made it through. Let's give them a round of applause. See? night and day, sweating and tearing up because they wanted to settle for less. I told them, you ain't gonna give up right now. I was so proud of them the first day they came to class. I still remember the first day they kind of struggled through the routine. But I kept pushing them, pushing until they accomplished the routine I assigned. Pablo pushed through. He was my first student in this program. I still remember the days I worked with him. I remember one of my clients, my student, telling me, how can I get the perfect body? The perfect body happens from the inside out, not the outside in. A number on a scale, your body percent fat, these things do not create the perfect body. The perfect body consists of two things. Number one, we have to stop comparing ourselves to other people. This is part of dealing with insecurities. Number two, we have to love ourselves for who we are. We cannot give other people what we're not willing to give ourselves. Self-love, self-respect, and self-confidence. So, you know, in order to reach a goal, we all have to do a routine. For the past 25 weeks, my students and I worked on a routine. Oh, wait, my bad, the wrong slide. This is the cheat meal routine. This is actually the real routine. Raise your hand if you think you're up for the challenge. In your brochures, this information will be included inside. I gladly encourage you to partake this challenge. It only takes 10 minutes. 10 minutes. What's your excuse? Only 10 minutes of your day. And I guarantee that your life will feel much better. To show you a better example of what fitness is, I need a brave volunteer that will come up on this stage and help me out. Anyone? You're right there, Brian! Come on! Woo! Clap it up! Get up! I'm gonna give you 20 sit-ups. No. All right. Would you do it for a delicious, warm, glazed donut from Katie's Donuts?
I sure will.
All right. Lay down, Brian. Count with the audience. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come on, Brian. Come on up. Wait a second. Brian, a donut. Okay. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20! How do you feel, Brian?
I feel good. I
want a donut. You want a donut? You want the whole box?
I want the whole box.
All right. Make sure you share, though.
Okay.
Round of applause for the gentleman. I just wanna know that feeling's in your heart when the beat drops out and the- Isn't it a happy Friday? That's right, that's what I want to hear, woo!
Still be there for me,
well, you know, I have to come to a conclusion. Teachers, students, staff, and director of Raw. We have the gift of life. We have to live it with passion. It doesn't matter what happened to you yesterday. It doesn't matter what happened to you 2 days ago. What matters is, how are you going to make every day better? You see, I changed your attitude with just a simple physical activity that took less than 5 minutes. Imagine what an hour can do. I taught you how to deal with fear and gave you helpful tips. I taught you about insecurities and how to deal with them. After this talk, I want you to go out there and take this message and use it in the real world. Thank you for my talk. And remember to always, always exercise and live life. When the beat drops out. Oh. And remember, always, always choose joy.
Oscar, you forgot your gym bag.
Oh, yeah.
You're gonna be late to the gym.
Later, you guys. I'll see you guys next time.